Добрый день, уважаемые коллеги. Добрый день.
Good day, dear colleagues. Good day to everyone listening.
Сегодня на Nobel Forum, на
Today at Nobel Forum, at one of the early morning sessions, we're opening a session with Ferroni Company, and on behalf of the Skolkovo Foundation, I'd like to introduce the speakers once again. Ferroni Company is the first regional partner of the Skolkovo Foundation in its whole history. Thank you very much, dear colleagues. Thank you for being with us this morning. Today's session is devoted to the market of doors and locks for those doors, the market of real estate where those doors are used. And today we have leaders of functional departments within the Ferroni Company, namely economics and finance, commerce, construction and development, production department, and biometric access systems and advanced technologies. Thank you very much. Good day, everyone. So a brief introduction of the company. I'm giving the floor to Oleg Knyazkov, just a couple of minutes for your introduction, and then we'll discuss the topics that we have on the agenda. Thank you, Vlad. So, colleagues, what is a door? First of all, it's security, comfort, and innovation, of course. We're very thankful to the Skolkovo Foundation for letting us go through all the stages of inspection and audit. We're now looking for new technological solutions. Why we're doing this? Well, because the company is growing very fast over the last 15 years. We've become not only the biggest manufacturer, door manufacturer in the country, but also the biggest exporter. We're also continue to be the exclusive exporter of our product, supplying to 16 countries of the world. And now we're working on our product range, looking at the latest trends, keeping an eye on where the market is going in developed countries, developing our own technological solutions. And in this connection, of course, we require lots of different competencies, skills, and sets of knowledge. And we count on Skolkovo in different collaborations in this regard. And we really hope to see the launch of the accelerator program really soon. And we have a lot of topics we want to discuss today. So, Vlad, can I ask you to moderate the discussion today? Yeah, exactly. Thank you. My first question I was going to ask was addressed at you. But for the goals of the accelerator and for the goals of today's session, I'd like to hear briefly about what is Ferroni. Today, Ferroni is about 2 million doors made each year. It's a company that occupies a dominating position in the market. Our workforce is about 5,500 people strong. That's a big team. Basically, we work in all price sectors, from economy to premium segments. For the moment, we have launched the biggest door manufacturing facility in the city of Tolyatti. In 2022, this production facility will hit its capacity of 7,000 doors per day. Internally, we plan on expanding the production of door furniture. Over the last 5 years, imports into Russia have reduced by 3 times, thanks to us, because we began making those items in Russia, replacing imports. And at the same time, we have a very rapidly growing export segment, doubling year on year. And that says that the product range that we have and the quality of what we make is up to all today's challenges and customer needs. Thank you very much. So let's speak about the challenges and customer needs. Very exciting topic indeed. Let me share this slide on the screen. And my first question is to you, Oleg. Where is the door industry going? Are we going to see doors as a service on the market, not as an item of furniture? Will there be like rooms as a service? Where the market is going? Well, sure enough, the market is going towards the full suite of services from production to mounting of the doors. I think Maria will tell us more about this. And of course, a door is becoming more of a pass or an instrument of managing a house, because in many developed countries these days, doors already include smart home management solutions, security cameras, internet connectivity, elements of IoT.
Состав самого изделия.
Other trends are for, well, modification of the doors themselves, with metals being replaced with high tensile composite elements. That's well, a new trend.
Даже металл имеет право быть замененным.
And we see that even steel has well, has a chance to be replaced, and we are keeping a close eye on all this.
Быть впереди.
And getting ready to stay ahead of the whole world, just to keep up with the changes and to keep our product the best in the market. Yeah, thank you, Oleg.
Как компания вот работает именно сегодня?
Can you give us an idea on what the company is doing today, how it's working today amid the pandemic?
Очевидно, оказало влияние на каждый.
Which of course has affected each and every business. I'd like to give the microphone to Alexander Laptev.
Вы как лидер,
you, as the leader of production at Ferroni, what can you say? Has the pandemic changed the way the company works, or is everything the same? Well, the orders have become more complex with advanced elements like advanced locks and advanced technologies. And well, to suit this, we're working on automating our equipment to make work easier for the employees. And the use of new sustainable and energy efficient technologies allows us to save the company's resources, where automated machines make operations that would take qualified workers much more time. We're always in search of such solutions. Thank you.
Спасибо, Александр. А вот Петр, вы тоже с нами на Zoom.
So,
Петр Воронков.
Петр Воронков, head of service department. So who's taking the decision, actually? Who's taking the decision on what door to install in future? Will these, the way such decisions are made, change? Well, I think I should touch upon the topic of how it's going right now. Right now it's pretty random. It's done by freelance workers, I mean, door installation and so on. Customers don't know whether they will return a call or not. And the future belongs with aggregators, I think, much like Yandex, where everything is automated. And the customer sees all the way from the moment an application is placed, an order is placed, and to the moment the assembly team actually comes to the premises. I think the evolution goes that way. And we have been taking a number of steps to be the first in taking up this trend. Thank you, Peter. Indeed, this is interesting. We at the Skolko Foundation, we visited the opening of your production facility in Tolyatti. We saw the assembly lines, what Alexander and Peter have been talking about. And of course, the door production will sooner or later will actually move to the client's customer's premises, and doors will be finished there, I think, ultimately assembled. And what do developers think about this? How does your cooperation with the developers and construction market is going? Well, indeed, we're just in the beginning. We're just starting to work with developers on a full cycle solution for customers, from design to mounting and post-sales retention. So we do the entire set of services in this regard. Indeed, we strongly believe, and we will tell about this later, that the spectrum of services will be much bigger, much wider, because we don't yet know the entire set of services required, and together with developers we're going to find it and implement it. So, Екатерина,
готов за это платить покупатель, да, за что он платит сегодня?
Are customers ready to pay for it? What are they paying for today and what will they be ready to pay for tomorrow? Well, for years doors have been seen as, well, something that, well, has to close a gap in the wall. And as a rule, builders would just install the cheapest options just to get the building commissioned. And once residents would move in, they would replace the doors.
Декором. Ну и потом, когда уже обживали, ставили уже дверь получше.
То есть третью уже.
Да.
And then there would be the third door, the real, the good door. So the cycle continued of actually three doors. And now we see a trend where construction companies install, well, pretty good doors already, and once the residents move in, they don't have to replace the door as a whole, but they could change the core. Well, they could change the covers, install some gadgets or new handles, biometric locks, something like this. So basically, it's a Lego that you assemble. And what customers are ready to pay for being involved in the process of creating the door, for security and safety, of course. And they're ready to pay not for just a door, but for an element of decor, an object of art in an apartment. Because if we look at the latest exhibitions, they're not just doors, they are objects of art indeed. So, Oleg, are customers ready to pay for art? I mean, door buyers, are they ready to pay for art? Because from what I've heard from Екатерина, we see step two taking the place of step one, and the third door is actually taking the place of the second door. Indeed, the market has grown, has evolved, and so have customers. They are, well, they're becoming more careful about spending the resources they have, and now they realize that they don't necessarily have to spend on three doors. Where you can start with installing one good door, that would be so adjustable, so customizable, like a Rubik's Cube. At different times, from renovation works to commissioning and to moving in, and that allows configuring and adjusting, well, the apartment to certain tastes and individual designs. And this, of course, has an effect on the door manufacturers. We realize that the market is changing, that the medium price segment and the younger generation of customers, they are going and moving into a different world where everything is digital. And this changes the, well, the consumption patterns. This changes new products that we have to suit to adapt to. So the doors, non-standard doors, advanced doors with elements of smart house, they take about 3% of the market in developed countries. Yeah, let's make an emphasis on that. With digitalization and new doors and 3%. And let's try to drive them to 30%, I think, because I'll go through it briefly at the end of the session, because we will be presenting this material at the website that we're launching together. So we're going to have four directions of searching: biometric access systems, video analytics, engineering solutions for Feroni's production and manufacturing facility, and the most interesting that should be in the biggest print is the door market and engineering solutions.
Yep.
Thank you very much. We will be starting a joint program in December. Feroni Tech, sk.ru, and on behalf of the Skolkovo Foundation, I will be leading the process, and I hope very much that together with the foundation, we will go to the construction market and to end market and to strategic partners of Feroni with a new solution that will help us drive this market share from 3% to 30%. Thank you very much.
транспортно-логистический холдинг «Российские железные дороги». Мы развиваем транспортную инфраструктуру страны, строим новые станции, вокзалы и создаем новые возможности для вашего бизнеса. Лучшие скоростные и высокоскоростные поезда сделают ваше путешествие комфортным и безопасным. Мы – локомотив экономики. Сотни миллионов тонн грузов ежегодно. Развитие науки и социальной сферы – это наш вклад в благосостояние страны и ваша уверенность в завтрашнем дне.
Есть история фантастическая. Есть история сказочная. Есть страшная история. А есть история реальная. Юка. Всегда реальная история и диагностика автомобилей с пробегом. Юка. Официальный сервис Hyundai. Смотрите историю и диагностику автомобиля и покупайте его онлайн.